Hello, my name is Ben Taransky, and I'm the president of Clear Vibrations Incorporated. We are located in Quakertown, Pennsylvania. We have one store location at this point, and we've been in business for 8 years. I started the business behind my house in a little two-car garage. I could barely get one truck like partway into it, and you know, we moved once 5 years ago, and we just moved again a year ago to our current location. It's at 6,000 square feet. We've worked ourselves up to 8 employees, two of which we just brought on in the last 2 weeks. We just happen to find the right people now, and you know, we're building our team. We do a lot of 12-volt installations. You know, we build our own displays for our head units. We do custom stereo. We also do some fleet management and stuff, you know, with telematics and, you know, being able to find our vehicles. And we do a lot of repairs for other shops or the do-it-yourselfers. Our mission statement here at Clear Vibrations is to treat every customer how we would want to be treated when we walked into a facility. You know, kindness, respect. We want to make sure everyone has the same experience. Doesn't matter if you're driving a Corolla or a Ferrari, it doesn't matter. Everyone should be treated the same and get the same attention. Our sales for the last 3 years have been positive. We've been growing consistently at a decent pace. We had a little plateau last year. Now it's just in the fourth quarter into the first with a very warm winter here in the Northeast, and with all the political stuff happening too, it just kind of slowed everybody down. Right now everybody's kind of full steam ahead, just like everybody else is seeing in the country with everything happening. And we have a positive outlook for the next 4 years, and until our lease is up, we're hoping to be purchasing our own property and have our own facility that we own. That's our goal for 4 years from now. I would say our biggest challenge that we had to face this year was our move. We moved here. It's been just a year now since we got the lease for this building. And so we moved over here. It needed a ton of work. We had to knock, actually you're looking right through where a wall used to be. And there's, you know, we had to put a ton of money into it to get it to where it's at now. It's finally close to where we needed to be. So it sucked up a lot of time and resources and finances to get us here. And you know, finally a year later, I think we're pretty close to where we want to be, and we'll show you with our walkthrough. So what makes me feel we're ready for the top 50 for Mobile Electronics Magazine? It's something we've been striving for many years now. It stems back to one of my first trainings that we got. You know, with a DAS show, they had Del Ellis there and helped us with my sales performance, and then also they had Brian Schmidt there, and you know, he said, take a picture of your store. This is back when I had my garage behind my house, and I did that, and it floored me. I went, oh, yeah, we need to clean this place up. You know, it's like, and we did what we could with what we had at the time, and it's a good reason that we started moving up and moving to the new places. And that's why we're where we're at today. And we want to progress and get to the point where we are in the top 50, and we are consistently are, and we're surpassing that. And you know, I feel we're finally at the level where I feel I can submit and feel like we deserve it. You know, we've been really trying, we've been really pushing our store to get to the next level and the product that we produce, you know, and with our work. So that's our story.
Well, when you pull into our parking lot, this is across the street from us. He's actually a world-known artiste. He's actually done stuff like movies like Armageddon, stuff like this. Like, these things are huge. I mean, they're like 20. That one there is like, you're talking 40 foot tall, you know? But so it's something for people to wander around and look at when they have to wait for half an hour. So here's our front of our place. You know, it's a kind of a strip mall type, or it's all businesses, you know. So the main entrance is on our right here. So walk on in. Got our little, be mindful of the COVID stuff. Water on in. Yeah, try and keep auto focusing. That's our COVID distancing table. Got some drone stuff. We need some more newer pictures. So this is just walking in the front door. These are our displays for radios. Sony, Kenwood, Alpine. We made all these, those three. And CompuStar. We'll probably add another one of those for next year. We have some fleet stuff coming up next, and that's our EchoMaster. And Big Wheel, 26s. We can do them now. That's a consumer-facing bathroom, one of them. So one of our sound rooms, the Phoenix Gold. Audio Frog will be in another corner. We had the display, it's just got to get loaded up. That's some, you know, trophies. They're from when I was competing. One of my trucks. So walk down the hall. Like, this is like where, you know, we stick people. You know, coffee machine. Try and keep them separated from us a little bit. Here's our second sound room. It's got our Audison display. Got a GS9 on there. Another display. It's got all of our Hertz and Audison and some of our Audio Frog for now. And we're using this room over here for like accessories, for like just the show wiring that we need, the sound deadening. You know, some of the single DIN radios, we just show them on a box. That's all we do. And that's the showroom, the store slash showroom. All right, let's take a quick peek at the back here in the garage. So that's a F350. That's a 69 custom cab, something special. So this is our original side we took. Upstairs is all the, all of our inventory. Then we took next door here. We gotta knock this whole wall down. But Steve's section, Nissan we're doing. We did get a wheel and tire machine this year. That was a big purchase for us. And then, yes, we have a wood room. That's down there. It's our, just a break room. A display we're working on. It's for all of our telematics stuff. And here's our wood room. We gotta tear this down next, once we get a chance and get started, redo it. And little quickie at my office, it's a mess. So that's our shop. So we can get about six vehicles in here easily. And if we need a squeeze, we can squeeze.